Now more on our top story this morning, and Oprah Winfrey has hit back at those reports that her recent trip to Australia with 300 of her audience members left her feeling empty. She spoke exclusively to 10's entertainment reporter Angela Bishop to explain how her comments had been taken out of context.
Whatever is being misinterpreted as, you know, me leaving with a sense of emptiness is absolutely not true. It just absolutely is not true. It's completely taken out of context. And I'm disappointed that that has happened, but that's why I'm happy we can talk through Skype to clear it up.
It's come from the screening of the fabulous behind the scenes specials you've done, which is screening on the OWN network here. And we did get a chance to really see how amazing an experience your Australian adventure was for you. And it was, wasn't it?
Well, it was the most, I would have to say, I would say, other than spending 10 days at Nelson Mandela's house and have 29 meals with Nelson Mandela, it is the single other greatest experience of my life and career to be able to come to Australia and meet the Aussies and be a part of that whole experience with 302 audience members. And just to see that on the other side of the world, people have the same feelings, same ideals, share the same hopes, dreams, ambitions. That was incredible for me. It's one of the top two experiences of my lifetime. Nelson Mandela, 10 days at his house, 29 meals, and Australia, okay?
We'll take that. That's good. Okay. But a couple of bits of the show do seem to have been taken out of context in a couple of reports that have been written in Australia, including how you remembered the pronunciation of the Prime Minister's name.
Well, I think that the biggest mistake anybody can make in an interview, and maybe you have made this a couple of times also, is to mispronounce somebody's name. You obviously, in any conversation, if you mispronounce the name, everything else you say has no credibility. And I think the highest level of respect you can give to somebody is to try to at least get their name right. And so when you look at the name, it looks like it can be pronounced Gillard. And so I was playing a mind game with myself, Gill and Lard, to make sure I didn't say Gillard instead of Gillard. It's as simple as that. I mean, no disrespect intended, of course, to the Prime Minister. Only the most utmost of respect, because I was trying to not to slip and say ja instead of gil.
Some reports also mentioned that you felt an emptiness following the Federation Square day in Melbourne. What did you mean by that? What did you mean by emptiness?
I felt that it was all about me coming and saying hello, and I didn't feel like I actually made a meaningful connection. What I said to them was, you know, people got dressed, they showered, they took a train, they took a bus, they drove themselves, they came with their friends. And in the end, they said, you know, hi, Oprah. And I said, hi. And that was it. I would have, you know, preferred that I had the opportunity to say something more meaningful, to leave people with something that they felt that they could, you know, take away, or give them something that they felt that they could actually take away. So the emptiness did not come from anything that the audience did. It was because of the way I felt we, as the producers of that event, set it up and created what I thought was a missed opportunity to have something really meaningful.
Did you feel unsafe at any time? Were security levels okay?
No, and I will tell you that when I looked at the behind-the-scenes episode, you know, as I preview them before they go to air, I called up the executive producer, Sherry Salat, and I went, what is the big deal? What is everybody talking about? Security, oh, security, and security, and security. And she said to me, well, it was as much about the people, the crowds, and being able to control the crowds and manage the crowds. And they didn't feel that they could do that on the tram, because originally we were going to be on a tram, and they didn't feel that they could handle that on a tram. And so that's what all of that conversation was about, because I felt the same thing. When I saw that, I went, well, was there some kind of security threat? Was there some kind of, you know, sniper situation? I didn't know what that was. So the security, as was explained to me by my team, was as much about, the security conversations were much about how do we protect crowds of people as well as yourself.
Oprah, thanks for talking to me today. It's been great to catch up, and thanks for clearing all that up. I think Australians understand that you had an amazing adventure, and it's great to hear that from you.
Okay, Nelson Mandela, Australia. Nelson Mandela, Australia.